Hello guys, and welcome back to another tutorial for MCreator. So today what we're going to be looking at is the voted in tutorial for the Ore Detector. So you guys saw the video clip where we basically tested for Diamond Ore. We can actually hold shift and then right click, and then we can change the mode for it. So if you want to search for pretty much any kind of ore that's in Minecraft, we can do that by right clicking and or shift and then right clicking on a block or the air, and that will cycle the actual contents. So when you have finished cycling it, what we can do is we can basically just right click, I think it's right click, yeah, right click the area, and it will detect where, if there's ore within that direction, that basic cube. So anywhere from 0 to 255 it will test for, but only below the block, I think, if I'm correct. And it will basically test for all that. So as you can see in the tutorial, if we go all the way down here, there is diamond ore down here as well. So we can also test for iron, so we know there's some iron there, and we can basically just go up to the surface and cycle to iron. We'll test, there's some iron right here, there's iron here, some iron over there. So yeah, it's a pretty handy little thing. If you're in survival, it takes damage, so if we go to game mode and then select survival, every time you right click it'll take some damage. It does have some durability, and you can customize the message if you want. So let's get into MCreator and I'll show you how it all works. Okay, so first off, there is only two procedures that you need to work on. I've tried making it as compact as possible and I think I did a good job. The two procedures that you need is we'll look into the procedures in this section. Let's go to the element itself. We have a basic item, I think. This is a item. Yeah, it's just a regular item. It's nothing too special. So, basically, or is it a tool? I think this is more of a tool, isn't it? Yeah, it's a tool. So, I have it under tools. I've given it a GUI name. It's the tool type is special, so it basically isn't any of the previous tools that would be considered an actual tool. Multi-tools are basic ones that are can be more than one type of tool, so I just went with special because then you have to define it. I've given the harvest level to 0, efficiency 0, enchantability 0, attack speed is 1, and the damage versus mob deals a half a heart. The number of uses I've set, this is how many times it can be used before breaking. This is basically 100. You can change this as much as you want. And the repair item, this is the item that you would use in the anvil to repair it. This is redstone or whatever you want to change it as. And the rest I've basically left blank. And over here I have made two conditions. The first condition is, or trigger is, when right clicked on block, and then there is when right clicked in air. Let's take a look at the when right clicked on right clicked in air, and this is basically what I have set up. It's testing if the player is sneaking. So as you can see, this is the code for changing the mode of the actual detector. So if the player is sneaking, then what we're going to do is we're going to test for the type of mode that it currently is. We're using a item NBT tag. So if you're not familiar where those are, if you go under item procedures, and then there's also item NBT tags here that you can add to your conditions and stuff. You can also set item NBT tags. So what I've done is I've tested for the previous or the current MBT tag. So in our example, we're testing for text-based MBT tag that is called under lowercase or and then mode. So or mode, and then the value of that needs to be col with a capital C. So if that's true, then what we're going to do is we're going to change the mode for that particular variable. So we've basically set it to iron, which is the next one, and then we'll test for the iron and then change it to lapis and so on. We also output a message. You can also use color codes in these messages too. So I've color coded the messages to display kind of like a similarity of what kind of ore it is as well. So iron's kind of like a gray color, lapis is blue, etc. And I've made it basically generate. So with that being said, that's basically all that happens here. It just basically cycles the thing, and then at the end here, it basically, if none of these conditions are true, what I've done is basically if there is no variable set, we're basically setting the variable to col. So I've created a simple else statement at the end. If I open up this, you can see that all these are the regular conditions that it will run, and then the else condition, if it doesn't have a variable set, it will put it in the else statement. And for that, we've just set the default setting to col. And with that, we also display the message. So when you first right click without any durability or after you crafted it, it will always be in col. And that's all there is going on there. So let's go into right click on block. And it's a little bit more complicated. It's pretty repetitive actually, but I'll try explaining it as best as I can. So we need a local variable. To create a local variable, you want to go up here, click on the green plus icon. You want to give your variable a name, and then you want to select number variable, and then click OK. I have a Y pause or pause Y or position Y local variable for storing the Y coordinates. So what I've done here is I've basically set the or tested if the player is not sneaking. And in that, I've basically tested it for the current Y location of what block that's being right clicked on. And then what I'm doing is I'm getting the Y position and testing if it's greater than zero. So that's basically testing if the bottom of the world, so if you're say between, if you're at like 64 or whatever and you right click on the block, it doesn't continue going past bedrock. So we always want to make sure that it's stops running the script around zero. So that's basically a catch for it. That will make more sense when we go on to the repeater part. So the repeater here is set to 256, which is exactly the Minecraft world height. So if you're at the top of the world and you run the procedure, then it will do it 256 times from top to bottom. That's perfect, but if you're somewhere, if you run the script somewhere in the middle, then it's going to go a little bit further beyond and might cause some issues. So we have a little catch right here just to make sure that's not going to happen. And inside of that, we're basically testing for our or mode, which is the or mode, the variable that we set, and getting the variable type. So if it's col, then it's going to be testing for the Y position. So now we're going to be grabbing the variable for the Y position that we just set. So we know that it's now set to the current location. It's going to be running 256 times. That will make more sense, but we haven't basically lowered it down to a lower number that will be run at the end of the script further down here. See, so we've basically set the Y position and then we get the Y position and then we set it to negative one. So that will lower the detection level below the current block. So with that being said, what's happening, it's testing for the current location of the variable, and we're testing for the type of block that we want. Now this can be any block that you wish. If you wanted to test to see if there's a mine shaft below, you could try finding planks or cobwebs or something like that. That would work too. And then we're just basically outputting a message when it's true. We're saying found ore, and we're setting all the color codes and stuff like that as well. And we're doing that for every type of ore. And when it's running this procedure, it's going to run it 256 times. And when it's finished with that, inside the repeater, it's going to subtract one. So with that being said, the last thing that we have is just some mechanic stuff. We're testing if, or basically getting the item to swing in the player's hand. And if the player is not in creative, so any other mode but creative, we're basically having them damage the tool. And then we're going to test if the tool is has equal to or less than zero. If it's equal to or less than zero, then it's going to play the item break sound, or entity.item.break sound, and then it's going to remove the item. So that's just basically the breaking mechanics for it. So outside of that, that's all there is to it. I know it looks a lot complicated, but these are just testing for multiple different types of ores. So really you just need this little section right here and this procedure right there, and then the rest of it, all these are just extra, basically extra ones that make up all of the ore. So outside of that, I will provide the link to the Ore Detector on my website. You can download the project like usual. And if you're new to my channel, don't forget to subscribe, comment down below. See you guys next time. Thanks for watching. Peace out.